Morning. We've been for a walk. I'm working on the knives in the back. Restaurant knives and the 734 knives. I got all the scratches off of them. I've been on a sisal wheel. I'm getting ready to go on the buffing wheel with the green Japanese polishing compound. Stand by. Got to clean it up a little. You need two hands for this operation. I'll leave you for a little while. You're ready to go now. See, the stuff gets everywhere when you put that toothy thing on it. Okay. Well, I got the 2750 clamped in and just finished up the 400 grit. It's going to be a nice knife. It's 22 degrees here. I don't know what the angle is. I had to match this angle that was on there, so I don't know what that is, but stand by a minute. We'll go see what it is. 21.4, 21.40, 22 down there. 21, that's jumped to 25, and that moves around a little bit sometimes. Let's see what the other side is. 2075. So we're going to make a little adjustment on the right-hand side to get it into that. It's 2790 is actually what it is. I mean, 2090. That's not too far off. There it is, 2090 on that side. I had a little teeny bit of adjustment to make right there. Now we can go to work. I'm working on the 800, 1000 grit paddles now. And I got a feeling I'm not going any higher than 800. This guy's a bosun mate in the Navy. And he said he wanted it kind of toothy. Well, I told him I was going to make it toothy since I knew what he'd do with it, cut rope and stuff. So I don't think I'm going beyond the 800. I'm going 800, then I'm going ceramic and a little leather. You can see it's really nice now. This goes on all day sometimes. Poor Jack. He takes it. After a while, he'll get tired and he'll holler at it. She'll stop. But most of the time, he just sits back, just like you see him on his back. I got the other taquitos in the sink. Getting a little bath. This little big cleaver right here turned out nice. See the brass all shined up nice. I came in to get my sponge, some of my ceramic paddles. Where you going, big old Jack? Brown coarse ceramics. Give her hell, Jack. Tell her. Don't mess with me. Yeah. The water, a little bit of soapy water mixed in that sponge, it cuts down on the dust a lot. Well, I'm outside, so it don't make much difference. But if you do this inside in your shop or something, this water holds the dust down good, even on the diamonds. I don't know if you can see this baby or not, but she's shaping up nice. You know what happens after this? I go to the white side, then I go to the tapes, and then I go to a little leather. And we've seen enough of that. You seen one, you seen them all. Ain't much difference. This baby turned out nice. It don't hardly need to go on the leather belt. There's a little buffy place right there, and one right up near the tip. But I think she's fine just about like she is. Went a little light pass or two, maybe. It's a nice big old knife. $27.50. Leader's outside now. Big old Jack, he's walking around way over there looking for rabbits. There's a couple passes on the leather. Be home tomorrow. Cut some rope. Look what I got now. The Mohawks are coming. It's a reenactment axe. Guy uses it for reenactments. You don't want it for a couple of days. Nice taquito. I like it. Pretty nice ticket. This is my vise base for my vise. Cypress. It's Saturday morning, headed to the knife gig, but it's raining. Real light right now, but it's rained on and off all night. If it don't pick up, I'll be okay. My truck is loaded. I need a truck stretcher already. Look at that. God, a buzzard couldn't get in there. Stand by. I got a call from a guy last night. He said, I got so many knives, Max, it'll take two trips to pick them up. I'm picking up some from him this morning. I don't know what they're going to be yet. Stand by. Let's get in this mess and take off. just enough rain to make it miserable right now. Now my buddy Low Tide Tim, you know, I made a sharpener out of him. He's working this market right here, short drive market, what I worked once in a while, last year, you know, when we first set up. Nobody's even set up there yet. I gotta work there next week. He's gonna be out of town. There's the produce guy. He's set up. I'll be there next Saturday. Because this market I'm going to today, this is the last market in May. And after that, they're gonna be open every Saturday, just like the one at East Beach. And East Beach is gonna be open, so I'm gonna have to do some shuffling this year. I think I'm gonna work.
In half a mile, turn right.
I think I'm gonna work this market where I'm going today three times a month and work Ocean View one time a month, but I'm not positive about that. It all depends. Stand by, I gotta turn right here to somewhere and pick up these knives this guy wants. That's Beach. I'm looking for Bayberry. I got two tenths of a mile to go. Stand by. He was right. I might have to make two trips. You won't believe what's in that bag right there. It must have been sitting outside all last night. It's all wet. It's about to fall apart. I'll show you when I get to the spot, to the market. Now, the reason my truck is so crowded is, you know, it's raining, and I loaded it last night. Oh, yesterday afternoon. So I got all the sharpeners, and the only thing I got in the back of the truck is the generator and the buffer. I put that in there this morning. The tables I put in there last night, in the outside, in the pickup part. Inside, I got everything else I need inside, which I don't normally carry everything in here. But when the weather's like this, my new four-door truck works okay for that kind of operation. Look at them clouds. God, where's the sunshine at when you need it? Unbelievable. But that's life. Well, the bag fell apart. God knows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, somewhere around 17 in this pile. I'm getting set up now. It's raining a little bit heavier right now. You ain't gonna believe right there. That's the best of it. Wait till you see this taquito today. That's the well. The first customer walk up has got three pocket knives, an old maple, cold steel, and I'm not sure if I know what this one is. It says Dawson. He wanted a wicked edge, so I told him the price. I cleaned this one up a little bit. I ain't quite finished with it yet. This is a nice old knife here. Maple. Nice taquito. I'm getting them in plastic boxes. I got some restaurant knives right here. They do. Poor guy. Big global cleaver. Well, Victor Knox. No, I don't know what. Yeah, that's a Victor Knox. I don't know what that is. That's a in the Henkel and two boners. That's for this guy right here. These are ones I picked up this morning. And these, I think I showed you these already. I got two chef knives and about 8 or 10 steak knives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. I got to get back to you.
What's your name?
Max.
Hey, Max, I'm Mike. I'll see you in a little
okay,
bit.
Okay, Mike, thank you.
Thank you.
Cutco's. Two more Cutco's. And a big long forwards.
Four-wood slicers. I mean, long range, baby. I think this is a Henkel. No, it's a Horwich too. I don't know what this is. I don't see China nowhere, so that's... I should see China, though, but I don't see it. I got to go to work. Look at them tickets right there. Rash asparagi. Never been in a store yet. That's right. There's some fat hen eggs in here. I'm talking about fat eggs. I ain't talking about no baby eggs. I'm talking about fat. Look like turkey eggs. But they're not turkey eggs. They're chicken eggs. But they're fat baby eggs. Look at them. Good Google Mooga, they're so big. Well, we're shutting down. I'm trying to find the best of it for you. You have to take a nitro pill. There's the best of it. One of the vendors there sells leather products. He makes bags, custom bags, all kinds of stuff. Well, I was talking to him a couple weeks ago, and it's like old canvas material. I got him to make me a new, what do you call this thing? Apron. Got three holes at the bottom, two holes at the top, two places for pins at the top. North End bag. Had I known what he was going to charge me, I can tell you one thing. He'd still have it. And that's as far as I'm going with that. It's unbelievable. I'm that damn dumb. But anyway, it's pretty nice. But I'll never get over it. Now, let's get back to these knives that we picked up this morning. I got most of them just about finished. I got to just hone them up a little bit and do a little more refinement on the edge. There's 18 of them. I thought it was 17, but I miscounted. What's nice about it is, here's a four Gerber. This is a whole set of Gerbers. Well, I won't say a whole set. It's a set of what I got. It's a nice Gerber cleaver. It's a Gerber slicer. The tip was broke off. I put a new tip on it. And four nice Gerber steak knives. Now these babies are nice. That one there's got a bend in the tip. You see it? But the rest of them was beautiful. Nice little Gerber steak knives. Gerber makes some nice knives. Different kinds. People don't even realize it. Tramonis. I don't know where he gets all these knives from. You know, these are the Finnish fisherman's knives. This is a cool ticket right here, though. See what it is. Charade. Would have never believed it. That's a nice one, too. Anyway, that's that. I got to go back to work. Finish these up. But I only got about a half hour. I'll be done with them.